गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, इट इज 12th फिजिक्स चैप्टर नंबर 7 लेक्चर नंबर 3। इन दिस चैप्टर वी विल डिस्कस एलसीआर सर्किट। इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द एलसीआर सर्किट। इन दिस चैप्टर वी विल डिस्कस इट फर्दर। इन प्रीवियस टॉपिक वी कैलकुलेटेड that Z is equal to under root of R square plus omega L minus 1 by omega C whole square. That was the impedance we calculated in previous lecture. If omega L minus omega C will be 0, if this term will be 0, then Z will be equal to R. Or you can say impedance will be minimum. If omega L minus 1 by omega C is 0, it means omega L should be equal to 1 by omega C. So we will simplify it for omega. So omega square will be equal to 1 by LC. So omega will be under root of 1 by LC. That is angular frequency. At this frequency, impedance will be minimum. It is angular frequency. We can calculate frequency as well. F. Omega is 2 pi F. So 2 pi f will be equal to 1 upon under root LC. So f will be 1 by 2 pi into under root of 1 by LC. So that the frequency at which impedance is minimum. This frequency is called resonating frequency. And it is represented by f0. And if it is angular frequency, then it will be represented by omega 0. So f0 will be equal to 1 upon under root 2 pi, 1 upon 2 pi under root of 1 by LC. That will be f0, and omega 0, that will be equal to under root of 1 upon LC. So f0 is resonating frequency and omega 0 is resonating angular frequency. So at omega 0, circuit is purely resistive because there will be no role of L and C. Omega L and 1 by omega C, their net effective voltage will be 0. So the resistance will be offered only due to, opposition will be offered only due to resistance. So it will be purely resistive in nature. And because it is purely resistive, so current and voltage both will be in same phase. You can say phase difference will become 0. Now we will use analytical method for LCR circuit. In previous lecture, we calculated impedance using phasor diagram. Now we will use analytical method. This is the LCR circuit. L, C and R are connected in series. So it is series LCR circuit. And this is the EMF applied. AC supply is connected. So according to Kirchhoff's rule, applied voltage will be equal to drop. So applied voltage will be drop across this inductor plus drop across this capacitor plus drop across this resistor. So applied voltage will be IR, which is drop across this resistance, L di by dt, drop across this inductor, Q by C, drop across capacitor. So applied voltage will be equal to drop, which is Kirchhoff's rule, second rule. Now suppose current I is equal to I0 sin omega t is flowing through it. So from this I, we will find out di by dt. We will find out what will be Q, I already given. Then we will substitute the value of I, di by dt and Q in this equation. So from this I, we will find out what is di by dt. And for that, we will differentiate this equation. So if I differentiate this equation, this I is 0. Differentiation of sin omega t will be cos omega t. And differentiation of omega t will be omega. So it will be I 0 omega cos omega t. So that will be value of di by dt. Now we know the value of I. We know value of di by dt. Now we will find out what is value of Q. We know I is di by dt. I is equal to dq by dt. I is dq by dt cross multiply. Dq will be equal to I dt. So if we integrate this equation, then integration of dq will be q. And it is our aim to find the value of q. So dq will be, substitute the value of I, which is I0 sin omega t. So I0 sin omega t dt. I0 sin omega t dt. Integrate both sides. Integration of dq will be q. I0 constant as it is. Differentiation of sin theta we know is minus cos theta. So it will be minus cos omega t. Integration of sin omega t will be minus cos omega t. And it is omega t, so it will be divided by omega. So it will be equal to minus I0 by omega cos omega t. That will be value of q. Now we will substitute the value of I di by dt and q in first equation. That is, in this equation. We will substitute the value of I di by dt and q. So E will be I0 r sin omega t plus I0 omega l cos omega t plus 1 by c. Then substitute this value of q, I0 by omega cos omega t. So, E will be equal to I0 r sin omega t plus I0 omega l cos omega t minus I0 by omega c cos omega t. That will be value of E. Now, we will simplify it further. We will take this I0 outside. So in the bracket it will be r sin omega t plus omega l minus 1 by omega c cos omega t. We have taken this cos omega t common. Now I am multiplying and dividing this equation by left hand side by one factor. Right hand side by one factor. That factor is under root of r square plus omega l minus 1 by omega c whole square. I am multiplying by this factor and dividing by same factor. So it will be I0 now multiplied by this factor. It is r sin omega t divided by under root of r square plus omega l minus 1 by omega c whole square. Then this plus sign. Omega L minus 1 by omega C, omega L minus 1 by omega C, divided by that factor, and root of R square plus omega L minus 1 by omega C whole square, this cos omega T. Now let R upon and root of R square plus omega L minus 1 by omega C whole square is equal to cos phi. This term is equal to cos phi. And if you know the value of cos phi, then you can calculate what will be sin phi, because sin phi will be under root of 1 minus cos square phi. You can simplify it. You will get sin phi will be equal to omega l 1 minus 1 by omega c divided by under root of r square plus omega l minus 1 by omega c whole square. You can try yourself. Sin phi will be equal to under root of 1 minus cos square phi. Substitute this value and then simplify. You will get this result. Now we will substitute the value of cos phi and sin phi in this equation. R upon under root of r square plus omega l minus 1 by omega c whole square is cos phi. So this term will become sin omega t cos phi. And omega l minus 1 by omega c upon under root of r square plus omega l minus 1 by omega c whole square is sin phi. So this term will become sin phi into cos omega t. So it will become sin omega t cos phi plus cos omega t sin phi. So we will substitute these values. So E will be I0 and root of r square plus omega l minus 1 by omega c whole square. In the bracket sin omega t cos phi plus cos omega t sin phi. It is in the form of sin a cos v plus cos a sin v. So it will be equal to sin a plus b. So it will be I0 and root of r square plus omega l minus 1 by omega c whole square sin omega t plus phi. Where phi is the phase difference between current and voltage. And if we compare it with standard equation, then this term should be resistance, or you can say impedance. So impedance will be given by under root of R square plus omega L minus 1 by omega C whole square. So it is the same result, but analytical method is little bit lengthy, not difficult, but little bit lengthy. Comparatively, that phasor diagram was easier. So this is the impedance. Now what will be phase difference? Tangent phi will be sine phi by cos phi. Sine by cos is tangent. So we'll substitute the value of sine phi and cos phi. Sine phi is omega L minus 1 by omega C and root of R square plus omega L minus 1 by omega C whole square into upon cos phi. So it will and root of R square plus omega L minus 1 by omega C whole square divided by R. So and root of R square plus omega L minus 1 by omega C whole square will be cancelled. We will get omega L minus 1 by omega C upon R will be phase difference. So it is same result. So whether we use analytical method or phasor diagram, result is same. Phasor diagram is relatively easier, or you can say not lengthy. Calculation is simpler. So tangent phi is equal to omega L minus 1 by omega C divided by R. So if we know the phase difference, then we can find out time difference as well. What is the procedure? If phase difference is 2 pi, then time lag or time difference will be T, capital T, time period. If 2 pi angle will be traveled, then time taken will be capital T. So for one, if phase difference will be unit, it will be T by 2 pi, and for a given phase difference, phi, it will be T upon 2 pi into phi. So in this way, you can calculate what will be time difference. If you know the phase difference, then you can find out what will be time difference between a voltage and current. Again, now we are discussing this part. What are the possibilities? Omega L may be greater than 1 by omega C, it may be equal to 1 by omega C, or it may be less than 1 by omega C. So we will take all three cases. First case. If omega L is greater than 1 by omega C, so this term will be positive. It means tangent phi will be positive. If it is positive, then angle will be between 0 to pi by 2. So if it is 0 to pi by 2, that is a positive, angle will be positive, it means EMF will lead the current. EMF will lead the current. It means circuit will be net inductive. EMF is leading means current is lagging behind, and current lags behind when it is inductive in nature, so it will be net inductive. Due to this combination, it will be net inductive in nature. When omega L is equal to 1 upon omega C, so if both are equal, then their difference will become 0. So tangent phi will be 0, so angle will be 0. So that will be condition for resonance. So current and voltage will be in same phase, because phase difference between current and voltage is 0. So both will be in same phase. So current will be, or you can say circuit will be purely resistive in nature. Purely resistive. So resistance offered or impedance offered by the circuit will be only due to resistance. And current will be maximum because impedance is minimum, so current will be maximum. This condition is called resonance, when current is maximum in the circuit and it is purely resistive in nature, that condition is called resonance. So drop across inductor and drop across capacitors will be equal, then circuit will be in resonance, you can say that. So in a given circuit, suppose I take one example, suppose drop across inductor is 50 volts and drop across capacitor is also 50 volts. And some resistance is also connected in the circuit. Because drops across inductor and capacitors are same, so they will cancel each other. So it will be net resistive in nature. So if drops are given, then without calculation, you can say it will be purely resistive, or you can say circuit is in resonance. Condition is, drop across capacitor should be equal to drop across inductor. Suppose I say 200 volt EMF was applied, drop across inductor was 50, drop across capacitor is also 50, and suppose resistance is 50 ohms and we'll have to find out what will be the current. Then you can directly calculate current. Current will be V by I, that is 200 applied voltage upon 50 ohm resistance of the resistor. So 200 by 50, that is 4 ampere. So it resonance, you can directly calculate what will be the current. Only we'll have to consider what is the resistance. So that will be condition for the resonance and how to calculate the current. Next, if omega L is less than 1 by omega C, so in that case, omega L is less than 1 by omega C, so this term will become a negative. If this term will be negative, then tangent phi will be negative. It means EMF will lag behind. So means current will be ahead. And if the current is ahead, means it will be net capacitive in nature. So it will be net capacitive in nature. Now we are plotting a graph. Along x-axis I am taking omega, angular frequency or simple frequency f, omega or f, and along y-axis I am taking I. As angular velocity or angular frequency or simple frequency, if frequency will go on increasing, omega L and 1 by omega C, if frequency omega increases, then omega L will increase and 1 by omega C, so 1 by omega C will decrease. Omega L, that will increase with increase in the omega, and 1 upon omega C. So because omega is increasing, so it will decrease. So this part will go on increasing, this part will go on decreasing. At a particular frequency, both will become equal. The difference is decreasing, so current is increasing. At a particular frequency, both will become equal. That will be resonating frequency. Current will be maximum. And after that, again it will start decreasing. This difference will start increasing, so current will start decreasing. Initially, omega L was increasing. 1 by omega C was decreasing. After that, it will be reversed. This frequency at which current is maximum is omega 0 or F 0. Now, NCRT question 7.7, 10, 11, 15 and 16 are based on these topics. So, you can solve these numericals. Thank you.